yesterday, after we finished the class, I went to my yeshiva, and there was someone that ate there. I don't know why. That's a different problem, but that's what he did. And he was not there. He went to pray mincha. And then after a while, he came back, and he like grabbed like a piece of matzah and ate. And I told him, like, what are you doing? He said, I'm in the middle of a meal. I went to pray mincha, but I had in mind when I washed that I'm going to continue my meal. So I told him, you can't do that. It's a sahadat. It's like you distract your mind. You went to pray. And like we argued a little bit, and he didn't accept what I said, but I'm quite sure that I was right. And now today we're going to see who was right. Okay? So, היה אוכל בבית זה, הוא פסק סעודתו והלך לבית אחר. The guy is eating in one house, okay? It says house, but really it means like a room, okay? A room. He's eating in one room, and he stopped and went to a different room, yeah? Or another possibility, שהיה אוכל וקראו חברו לדבר עמו. Yeah? You eat in your house, and then somebody calls you from outside. Hey, can you come outside for a minute? You're going outside. So what do you do when you're coming back? Can you continue to eat? יצא לפתח ביתו וחזר. So you went out and you came back. הואיל ושינה מקומו, because the guy have changed his location, צריך לברך, he have to say the ברכה. למפריע על מה שאכל, meaning ברכת המזון, what he ate before, וחוזר ומברך בתחילה, המוצי, and then he have to wash again, to say המוצי again. Yeah? That's it.
This is super rough.
That's simply Shulchan Aruch before we're getting into the Mishnah Berurah, and there's many commenters, we'll see, Bezrat Hashem. אחר כך יגמור סעודתו, then he can finish his meal, okay? אבל אם דיבר עמו בתוך הבית, but if your guest is coming into your house, and while you're sitting at your table, or next to your table, you can chat with him, that's fine. אף על פי שינה מקומו מפינה לפינה, so you went from one corner of the room to the other corner of the room, אין צריך לברך, so you don't have to say another bracha, okay? רמה, אין לקמן סימן רישה אין גימל, אם היה דעתו לאכול מקום אחר, לא מקרי שינוי מקום. If the guy had in mind to eat in a different place, he doesn't call שינוי מקום. It's not distracting in mind. So that's what he was claiming. He was claiming, I had in mind, so it's fine. Okay? והוא שיהיו שני המקומות בבית אחד. Okay, so the רמה says that both of those places have to be in one house. What does it mean? Means that like it's one shade, one korat gag, one roof, and he's changing from one room to another. So that's what I said in the beginning, that when it says a house, bayit, it means a room. So from one room to another, inside of the same house, and the person had in mind when he said amotzi, he had in mind that he's going to change his location within the room, within the house, that will be fine, according to the simple understanding of the Rama. Okay? So far, so good. Let's get to the Mishnah Berurah. So the Mishnah Berurah says, "Aya ochel bebayit ze meiri beochel yechidi." Okay, first step of the Mishnah Berurah, we're talking about a singular person. Okay, if it's a group of people, that will be different laws. Let's see. Ve'im ochel beyachad im od anashim, if there's other people there, nisharu bnei chavurato bimkoman, and the same people were eating together, and his friends are staying, and he's going out and coming back. So then he doesn't have to say another bracha because he went out and came back. That will be fine, no problem. Okay. The command siman seif bet. Alach, so Mishnah Berurah bet. Afilu lo nishta sham klal. Okay, we didn't get to speak about how long it was. Mishnah Berurah points, even it didn't took long, just went out and came back, like split of a second, that will be the same thing. Shetechev chazar limkomo rishon, immediately came back. Afilu achi shinui makom mikri, still it's called shinui makom, it's a change of a location, he distracted his mind. Kol shiken im rotze ligmor sudato makom sheni. How much more so, if he wants to finish his meal in a different place. Okay? So this is something that is very, very casual by Hasidim, that they are starting their Shabbat meal in their house, and they have in mind to finish their meal with their Rebbe. So they're starting with their family, and they don't say the Birkat HaMazon with their family. The kids and the wife are saying the Birkat HaMazon by themselves, and they like going and continuing their meal and saying Birkat HaMazon with their Rebbe. Okay, that's like people that are like community that is you know, Hasidim and Rebbe, but that's something that is happening like every Shabbat. Very, very casual.
What about tea and cake with the Rebbe? The
Latin cake with the Rebbe, yeah. If they have Latin cake, maybe they have Kugel, I'm not sure exactly what. What?
They do it by Shalshut.
Loved Afka, it can be the first meal as well. Yeah, the Tish, the first meal.
What if a Zimmer isn't going to happen because of that? Then can they still do that?
If they have a chance for Zimun in their house,
yeah,
and by going away, so they're destroying the Zimun of their house,
yeah.
No, it's a problem. It's a problem.
So two adult boys.
Yeah, if they have, like, for example, two adult boys, and he is the third guy, so because he will leave, so probably in a case like that, he will take his boys with him, probably. But if he doesn't, whatever, so they can do that, like what they can do is that one of the boys will say the Zimun, and he answers the Zimun, and he doesn't say the Birkat HaMazon, and then he goes. Yeah, that's what you do when you have like an obligation of Zimun, and then you want to go to, like, you want to continue to eat, and someone wants to leave. So he says the Zimun, he says the Birkat HaMazon, and you can continue to eat. It's fine.
Good question.
Okay. Nachman Yosef, can you do me a favor and put some hot water here? Thank you very much. It's killing me to vote. Okay. What are you going to do? We're telling you also. Okay. Gimel. Mishnah Berakhot Gimel. Bait Acher. Hu Adin Lecheder Acher. Okay, so I said it's the same thing, that a house, it means a room. The Mishnah Berakhot seems to say that it's not the same thing, but it's the same law. Okay, we're gonna see later on. Gam ken bichlal shinu mekom. So another room is also a shinu mekom, is like changing place, changing location. If he had in mind before to change for a different location, different room. So the Rama says that it's not called shinu mekom. So that will be fine. Right? Good. So Mishnah Berurah Dalet. O shaya ochel, ashmunin baze, af al pi shelo pasak misudato klal, even though he didn't break his meal at all.
He's kele mitzvahs.
Shel koach. Baruch. Adonai. Baruch. Ha'olam. Shel koach. Amen. Okay. So the Mishnah Berurah is pointing that what the Shulchan Aruch is coming to teach us, that even though he didn't break his meal, he didn't have any intention to break his meal, for in his mind he's totally in the middle of his meal, and yet it will count as a break of the meal that he will have to say Birkat HaMazon and say Emotzi again. Okay. So he just, his friend called him outside. He went outside to his friend. That's it. Chazar, avikmo, shinui makom, bayit lebayit. So that will count as changing from one house to another. Mishnah Berurah, hey, petach beito, rotze lomar sheyatza chutz lepitcho. He went out of his opening. The im edaber imo al petach, en ze shinui makom. Okay, if he's just getting on the doorstep, and he didn't step outside. He's still like inside of the frame of the door. That doesn't count as shinui makom. Still the same place. Mishnah Berurah Vav, צריך לברך, דעל ידי היציאה ממקומו חשיב כנפסקה סעודתו לגמרי. Because going out of his place, so it counts as totally break in his meal. Whatever he eats afterwards is only a new meal. It's a different meal. So he have to say the Birkat HaMazon for what he ate, and to say Amotzi for what he's going to eat.
And wash again.
And wash again. And say Birkat Netilat Yadayim. He's gaining many brachot. Maybe it's worth it.
Yeah.
אוקיי, למפרע. במקומו הראשון, לכתחילה שרוצה לצאת ממקומו, צריך לברך בקעת המזון קודם שיעקב. אוקיי? So, this happening that was described by Shulchan Aruch is bedieved state. Okay, bedieved, if it happened, so what he should do, he should say begat amazon for what he ate, and then to wash and to say a motzi again. But lechatchila, if something is happening and the guy have to leave, yeah, he have to cut his meal in the meal, and he have in mind to continue his meal. Okay, so lechatchila he should say begat amazon before he leaves. And then to leave, and then when he comes back to wash again to say amotzi again. That will be the lechatchila, if he have to. כמו שכתב סעיף ב', רק בדיעבד שלא ברך מתחילה, צריך אחר כך לעזור לברך בגעת המזון מקומו, שכך הוא מצוותו, אחר כך יברך המוצי ויוכל מה שירצה, that's what I said in English before, משנה ברורה ח', חוזר ומברך בתחילה המוצי, okay, so he's saying המוצי again, והיינו כשעומד באמצע סעודת פת, meaning, המוצי, obviously, is when you're eating bread, right? What will be the same case, but it's not bread, is merely pasta, whatever. Yeah, not bread. What would be then? כל שכן אם לא אכל מתחילה, רק פירות או משכין, מדי שייך בו שינוי מקום. Okay, so the Mishnah Berakhot says, כל שכן, how much more so if it is something else that is not bread? Why is that? Because like within the halakha, obviously you know that we're giving like important place to bread, right? Bread is important. We have many reasons, we have many proofs. We don't need to say why. We'll know that bread is important. What is the halachic application of this special status of bread? That it is more of establishing a meal with bread. Meaning, when you eat a meal with bread, so it is more established. It's more like kviut in Hebrew. I'm not sure how to translate kviut in English. It's like setting yourself to a meal. Yeah. And with other things, so it's what they call like wishy-washy. You know, like you can eat a little bit here, a little bit nash there, you know, and even if you have a meal, but I don't know, like it's not an example to learn from. But I had a friend that before he did tshuva, so he was like whatever, and like doing some business in China, Japan, I'm not sure exactly where, and he told me that like every time they went to a meal, so they went out and they buy something, and they like while they're walking, they eat it, and then they sell something else, and they buy another thing, and they continue to walk. And you know, this is like it's a custom way of people to eat. Unfortunately, these days, that it's not, there's no like establishing a meal. It's not setting up a meal. It's just by the way. Everything is by the way. And then so bread, specifically for people that are religious, that give like the bread like the important place, as it should be. So then it will be more of establishing him. What will be the application of that? That it is harder to say that you distract your mind from a meal that you established. Okay? When you establish yourself to a meal, so then you're setting up, so even though you had something that distract your mind, but you like you know that you're inside of a meal. And even so, about bread, we do say that it's called that the changing location is called the sahadach, the distracting of the mind, and then, like we said, the kat amazon and amotzi again, right? So how much more so about other things, as we're going to see.
What is your the restroom is outside of the, most of the time back then, the restroom was outside of the
house. Right, right, right.
So would that
That will be, yeah, that will be shinui makom, to go to the bathroom in the middle of the meal. That will be shinui makom. So you will have to say the kat amazon and amotzi again. Rambam says, by the way, to like the person have to check if you have to go to the bathroom before he's starting the meal. One of the reasons is because of that. Because if he didn't, then he have to go to the bathroom in the middle of the meal. So there's all kinds of halachic questions. Not only that, even if it's in the house, because like you don't eat in the bathroom. So yeah, no one is eating in the bathroom except for whatever. If you want to tell you a story about it afterwards. But generally, people are not eating in the bathroom. So, because you don't eat there, so it's more of a break with your meal. Yeah. If you just talk, like going outside, so sometimes people like to eat outside, right? So it's a place that you could continue the meal there. But the bathroom is not a place that you could continue the meal there. So it's more of a break. Okay. So it's an issue. I agree. There's many people that they have like they have to go to the bathroom a lot, and then they get into this question a lot. We'll get to that.
How many times are you going to pension in 1 year?
Okay. Yeah, we're going to discuss it. Bezrat Hashem. But lemaisef, lechatchila, for sure, it's better to like use this advice of the Rambam. It's not the Rambam. It's in Gemara. But the Rambam also brings it in Achot Deot that the person have to check if he have to go to the bathroom before he starts his meal. Anyhow.
Has in mind that he might go to the washroom
in the middle of the meal,
because he has
tasks
that
he might
have to do.
Right.
Rabbi, by saying Birkat Hamazon, and then saying Hamasi again afterward, and beginning the meal again, is this a problem? Because in Masechet Yoma it says to only eat twice a day. Would this be a problem to say Birkat Hamazon with the intention of coming back and starting again?
There is like a concept of eating twice a day that Chazal are discussing. That was the custom in their days. But practically, most of the people today are accustomed to eat three times. And it's not like a halachic issue if somebody wants to eat like whatever, like 10 meals a day. You know, to eat a kazait and to have a break, and then to eat another kazait and to have a break. It sounds funny, but like he's not doing a sin by that. If he's washing and he's eating and he's saying a motzi and he's saying Berat Hamazon, so fine, whatever. So I don't think it will be an issue. Maybe it's not a good idea, but it's not a sin. Anyhow, so we'll get to speak about that point, that if a person have in mind that he will go to the bathroom in the middle of the meal. So you're right that the achronim saying that it will not count as a break in his meal, and he will be able to continue his meal. Okay, there is different opinions about it. So if somebody is able not to rely on those lenient opinions, and I don't know if it's leniency or stringency, but like to get out of the doubt, it's better not to go to the bathroom in the middle of the meal. So it's better to go to the bathroom before the meal. And then there's no doubts. But if something like that happened, the person, he knows that he will go to the bathroom in the middle of the meal. And it won't help it even if he will go to the bathroom before the meal. And that's what happens. Sure enough, that's what happens. He went to the bathroom in the middle of the meal. So then you're right that because he had money before he started, that's what will happen. So it's like b'dieved, he will not have to say the amotzi again. He will not have to say Birkat Hamazon and amotzi again. And the question will be about the netilat yadayim. That will be another question. Which kind of netilat yadayim? And if to say the bracha of netilat yadayim in this case, okay, that will be another question. Anyhow, let's continue with the Mishnah Berurah. Mishnah Berurah, we got to Chet. No, Tet. Mishnah Berurah Tet. Mipina lepina. One corner to another. Ainu b'oto cheder. So if somebody is like living in a studio apartment, as they call it, like a big room, that like that's the whole house. The whole like apartment is one big room. And he's moving from like the couch to the kitchen, whatever, but it's like it's one room. There's no walls there. So then it will apply what we read here. Yeah, he's moving from one corner to another within one big room. So then it will not count as a shinui makom. It will not count as distracting the mind, even if it can be like a little bit far, one from like one corner from another, but it's still the same place. Af she'ein ze nira lefanav mekomo rishon. So generally we will see later on that there is like meaning of if the guy see like the place where he started the meal or not. But here for that halakha, the Mishnah Berurah is pointing that even though he doesn't see the place of where he started, yeah, he doesn't see that. He went to like the other side of the room that is in far away enough, and there's something in the way that he cannot see where he started the meal, it doesn't count as changing his location. כמו תנו או פרן, כיוצא בזה, אין שינוי מקום, כיוון שהוא בחדר אחד. Okay, there's no, the law of שינוי מקום does not apply in when it's in one room. פרן is like a big oven as far as I know. No, מחיצת עץ. Like a mechitza, they divider that they is movable.
Okay.
So it's not like really dividing the room to two rooms, but you know sometimes they put like something like to hide the mess or to hide the bed or something like that. Yeah. So but it's one room, but they have like a certain.
Especially people who live in studio apartments.
Yeah. Yeah.
The Japanese etchings on it always.
Okay. Mishna Berurah. Mishna Berurah Yud. Yeah. Ayan lekaman rotze lomar de sham meiri linyan shinui makom legabei kiddush uadin linyanen. Okay, so we'll see further on about the changing of the location for the purpose of saying kiddush. Of kiddush. Meaning. Okay. No. We're not going to discuss it now. Yud Aleph. Im haya dato. If you have in mind, רוצה לומר שבשעת הברכה חשב לאכול גם במקום ארוך. So that was the case yesterday with this guy that he said, I had in mind. Yeah, I had in mind that I will go and come back. But here it says to go, that he had in mind to go to a different place and to eat there. So that's what I told this guy. I told him, if you had in mind to go to like wherever it is that you did your mincha and to eat there, and you ate there, and then you came back and you continued to eat here, maybe you could get out of it. Maybe. Okay? That's my understanding from the Mishnah Berurah. The person is also a rabbi. Like, he knows what he's not like a phony baloney. Like, he knows his stuff. Like, when he heard me, he said, if you're right, Hashem Yerachem Alei. Because he's doing that all the time. Anyhow, Yud Bet. בבית אחד, היינו תחת גג אחד. Okay, it's under one roof. אפילו מחדר לחדר, או מבית לעלייה. From one room to another, or from like the bottom floor to a loft, you know, that is inside of the same room, but it's like a little loft, like I have in my house. So it's anything like that. אף על פי שאין רואה את מקומו, even though he doesn't see his first location. ברוך השם. ברוך השם, ברוך השם. תודה רבה, תזכה למצוות. הוא הדין אם רואה מקומו הראשון שאכל שם, אפילו דרך חלון. So he see the place that he ate there, even through a window. Yeah? אפילו מקצת מקומו, even if it's just a little bit of that location. נמי מועיל, it also helps, אף על פי שלא ידע אותו מתחילה, even though he didn't have in mind before. Okay, so if somebody have to go out, and he keep on looking like back. So he's like, let's say somebody is calling you out, you're going out of the room, but you like all the time you like keeping like eye contact with the like your place where you are supposed to continue your meal.
Yeah.
Yeah? Not because of you that you're so like in the eating, because like you just don't want to have in the halachic problems that comes with it, obviously, right? דווקא מחדר לחדר באותו בית, אבל מבית לבית, so that's, again, that will help from one room to another, in the same house, the same roof. Okay? But if you're talking about two houses, that is one, like one in one side and one in the other side, even though they are close, yeah? They have like two doors that are one in front of the other, yeah? Two apartments. And it just like, a few steps from one house to another. Yeah, so it's like two rooms, right? Says the Mishnah Berurah, no, it's like two houses. כן, מסתפקים האחרונים דאפשר דאין להקל על ידי מקום על ידי מיריית המקום. Okay, so then there's a discussion. It's not like it's not smooth. It could be that it's not called Shinui Makom if you still see your first location, but it's not smooth anymore. מדעת לפי המבואר לכמן בהגעה, דיינו נוהגים כפוסקים שלא לברך על ידי שינוי מקום כשעומד באמצע סעודת פת. תו אין אף קמינא לדינא כל החילוקים האלו שהזכרנו שינוי מקום. רק לעניין מסובין לאכול פירות ושערי משקין. ובהם לכולי עלמא שייך דין שינוי מקום. Technology, huh? Wow. Kol hakavod. Okay, so here this Mishnah Berurah is the Mishnah Berurah here is saying something that it's a little bit goes to the direction of this other rabbi that I argued with yesterday, that the Mishnah Berurah here says that what we're gonna see in the Haga'ah, that our custom, meaning the Ashkenaz custom, is not to say the bracha about shinui makom when he's eating bread, when he's eating bread. And all of those rules will apply to other things, not bread. Okay? So we need to find like exactly what exactly is the definition of shinui makom for Ashkenazim according to the Rama. But we didn't get there yet, so wait. Good. So you all with me? We're reading Shulchan Aruch, Kufa and Chet, Seif Bet. Okay, Seif Bet. Chavarim sheyu yoshvim le'echol ve'yatsu. Yeah, people that were sitting together to eat, and they went out, likrat chatan, likrat kala, yeah? They hear like a wedding outside, like going in the street, so they're going outside to dance with them a little bit, whatever. Im enichu shem miktzatan. So if some people stayed around the table, chozrim lekomam, gomrim sudatan. So the people that went out to dance, they can come back and continue their meal, no problem. Enam tzrim levarech shnia, they don't have to say bekat Amazon to say amot sigel. Im lo enichu shem shum, lo enichu shem adam, but if there was no one left there, so when they are leaving, they have to say the Birkat HaMazon before they leave. And when they come back, they have to say Amotzi again. Okay? Also the same law. If it's not bread, it's wine or whatever, fruit. If you change your location, it's like you broke your meal, doesn't matter which meal is it. If you have mevarech lemafreya, so then you will have to say the Birkat HaMazon for what, or the bracha achrona for whatever it is that you ate or drank. Al ma she'achal v'chozer mevarech shenit al ma she'tzarich lechol. And then when you come back, you have to say the bracha rishona again. Meshana mekomo mipina lepina b'bayit echad, and if it is changing location from one corner to another inside of one room, ein tzarich lechozer levarech, you don't have to say the bracha again. אכל ממזרחה של תאנה זו, הוא בא לאכול במערבה, צריך לברך, okay? So that's something that is relevant for people that are going camping. So you don't have a house, so what do you do, right? So the Shulchan Aruch says, if somebody ate in the east side of the fig tree, and then he wants to go to the west side of the fig tree and to continue to eat there, because the sun was shining on him too strong, he wants to take the shade now. Whatever it is, yeah. So that will be called shinui makom. That will be called shinui makom. So the Shulchan Aruch, okay. Tzarich levarech. Okay. So there is a long Rama here, but instead of reading through the whole Rama here, I'm going to read the Mishnah Berurah on that piece of Shulchan Aruch, and then we'll continue with the Rama and the Mishnah Berurah that follows with that. Okay. So I'm reading Mishnah Berurah Yud Gimel. Likrat Chatan. Okay. לקראת חתן או לקראת קלה, הוא הדין שיוצא לדבר הרשות, doesn't matter if it is mitzvah, thing that he went out for, or anything else that he went out for, doesn't matter what's the reason. ענקת לקראת חתן, when it says for the חתן, why the Shulchan Aruch says that, לרבותה. To say, even if he had a very good reason to go out, he went for to make the חתן קלה happy. So he's doing mitzvah. Why he have to suffer now and to say, oh, Birkat HaMazon now? No, it's not suffering. It's a privilege. Anyhow, that's a different thing. ולא הניחו שם אדם צריך לברך בקעת המזון קודם שיצאו, אף שיוצאים לדבר מצווה. If they are not leaving anyone there, they have to say the ברכה האחרונה. If doesn't matter if it's for the purpose of מצווה. Okay. משנה ברורה י"ד, מקצתן אפילו רק אחד. It doesn't have to be like many people that stayed. It can be one person. Yeah? So like between, like in our house, so we custom to say like li et ha-seudah, like keep the meal for me. What does it mean? It means like I'm counting on you that I will be able to come back and to continue to eat. So like don't disappear now. Like if you're leaving someone and he decided he want to whatever go as well. So then you, like you know. So then you have to say the bracha achrona and to say amotzi again. So you have to. It's good to like the person that is keeping the meal for you will be conscious about it, and then it will be more smooth. Yeah. Okay. Tetva nevarich shnia anu bikat amotzi af shishinu makoman benatayim. Even though they changed the location in the meantime, Ivan Shinsha Mitzadan Command Lopaska Sudatan Baitsia. So he, because they left someone, it's not called a break of the meal. That Zain, Shem Yotzim, Hule, Ivan Shulani Husham Adam Nishtika Sudatan Baitsia. If they didn't leave anyone, so the meal is broken by going out. Shohel Hadka Havi Sudah Hadasha. And when he comes back, it will be a new meal then. Okay. What about when there is a class and some people are leaving in the middle of the class? Is that a break of the class? And then you have to say another bracha when you're coming in? That's another question. Yudzai. Shem Chuzrim. When they are coming back. Yeah. What happens when they are coming back? They're sitting down. באמת, כבר כתב זה בסעיף א', כף על הדברים, בשביל חידוש, שניח מקצת החברים. So that's in a case that he left some of his friends. In the meal, או למה שכתבנו בסעיף י' קטן ג', כן, י' ח', אם היו, מי שנברו י' ח', אם היו, השמועינן דגם בזה, מהני, הניח מקצת חברים, כמו בסעודת פת. So it's good if he left some guys there, for like the same thing, like סעודת פת, like a meal of bread. Okay? So, again, same thing about drink and fruits, it will be the same thing. The difference between drink and fruits and bread, that by bread, like the definition of a meal of bread is that they sit down to eat and they establish themselves to eating. But by fruits or drinking, so it can be that there's no kviut whatsoever. They didn't set up themselves to eat and drink. They just happen to eat and drink, by the way. Yeah,
and it doesn't make a difference if it's shekel or
yeah. In Yamin, maybe you want to. I think that there's something with the settings of the Zoom that, like.
Is that because
he can hear you?
No, he can hear me, but I'm like I have like those shining stars there.
Oh.
We were using like a background in the like night class of Lag BaOmer, so I think it's something that stayed from there.
Is that because with water or from drinking, you can drink from a river and like on the go, on the way, and also fruits you can just pick from a tree? And
again?
Is it because of they're saying fruits and water is like more on the go because you can pick it on the way and like drink it on the way?
it could be in this like way. It doesn't have to be in this way.
A tree.
It could be in this way. Yeah. Thank you, Benjamin. Mishna Berurah Yud Tet. Pasak achilato vegara ma'asach hadat she'en mevarchim rak bracha lechatchila shechozer lechol. Okay, so he said, the Mishna Berurah says that like by fruit or drink it will be worse than what we said about the bread meal. Why? That by bread meal you have to say the bracha. שאין מברכים רק ברכה לכתחילה כשחוזר לאכול, וזה נחשב כסעודה אחרת לגמרי. So, it's more of an obligation. Let's put it this way. By fruit or drink, it will be more of an obligation. Make it simple. יש נברו הקף, אפילו מברך, היינו שלא ברך ברכה האחרונה, קודם יציאתו, מברך אתה כשחזר, כמו לעניין פת. So, even though he is eating only is saying only the bracha achrona before he left, and now he's saying the bracha rishona. Yeah, so that's what we said. Kaf alef lemafriya, baze en tzech lechzor lemkomo davka. כף א', לפיכך מברך למפריע על מה שאכל, כן. So, to say, that's the difference. That's another difference between like bread and other things. That for bread, a person should say the bracha achrona in the same place that he ate. By other things, you don't have this obligation. It's good to say the bracha in the same place that you ate, but there's no obligation. So you can leave and say the bracha achrona outside. So because of that, it makes it that also by bread, lechatchila, you shouldn't leave before you say the bracha. But other things, you have the permission to leave without saying the bracha. Okay? Just don't forget, obviously. אינו יכול לברך אפילו במקום השני, רק פת מצוותו וכולי אלמא לחזור לברך במקומו. Okay, so by bread, if someone remembered that he left without saying Birkat Hamazon, he should go back to his place and say the Birkat Hamazon there. By other things, wherever the guy remembered, so then he have to say the Birkat Hamazon, the Bracha Achrona, wherever it is. Mishnah Berakhot Kaf Bet, Bayit Echad, Pirush B'Cheder Echad, Again, Abraham Sharachonim, Ayin Lekaman Shkedamnu Biru Alacha. Okay. So again, the house and the room, is it the same thing or two different things? Like I said, there's a discussion about it. There's a whole Biru Alacha about it. We're not going to discuss it right now, but it seems that in according to the beginning of the Shulchan Aruch, like I said, that the house and the room is the same thing.
What about the balcony? Is that like leaving the house?
That's a good question. I would say that the balcony is considered to be like another room of the same house, even though it might be without roof, but it's still like it's considered to be part of the house. And you see that Lamaisa, many people, they had the balcony and then they made it to be like another room, right? It's very casual.
But the garden people say it's a problem. Like you have a garden at home.
Again, even from one room to another, it's a problem. Yeah. So the garden, let's say that the balcony is easier to say that it's another room of the house. If it's like really outside on the lawn, whatever, so then it's harder, but it could be that it will count as part of the house. Yeah. For example, one of the applications of that. Like we have a yard here outside of the Bet Midrash. Is that yard have Kedusha of Bet Midrash or not? So Lamaise, people are praying there, people are learning there, right? So you see that we are relating to that like extension of the house, right? And many people that they have a yard, so they use the yard as another room of the house. So they have a table there and many times they eat there. So it depends also in the people. Yeah, there is people that they have a yard, but they never go out there. So it depends in like, but let's say that it cannot be closer than another room. So if for another room, we say that the person have to see his first place, so also about the yard, it will be the same thing. So even if you're going out to the yard, that it will count as not Shinui Makom, it must be that you still see the place where you started your meal. And then maybe you can be lenient about it to count it as another and as a, like another room of the house. Okay. Mishnah Berurah, Kaf, Dalid. Yeah? We did Kaf Gimel? Yeah, I think, no, Kaf Gimel. Let's do Kaf Gimel. Eno tzarich, av shina mekomo legamrei, lechol bezavit acheret, en tzarich lechzor ulevarech. So even in the same room, even if he went to the totally other side of the room, he doesn't have to say another bracha. It's not counted as changing your place. Even though you don't see your first location, because it is a different room. Zavit, it can be also an angle, but it can be also a corner of the house. I said one time why people like in every Bet Knesset, every Bet Midrash, you always see someone that is in the corner. Why like every many times you see like people that are looking to be in the corner. Why? Because Torah Monachat Bekerem David, that's where the Torah is. Torah is in the corner. So people want to be there in the corner. Anyhow. Kaf, Dalit. Achal b'mizrecha. Ein chiluk ben she'achal shampat, o she'ar dvarim, she'achal pirot. Okay, it doesn't matter if he's eating like bread or something else, and even the figs of the tree. So he is eating in one place, and then he's circling the tree. Okay, I'm not sure, but I'm my understanding is that he's talking about a fig tree. Yeah, it's not a fig tree, it's a fig tree. So like he's going from one side of the tree to the other side of the tree, so he doesn't see the place where he started like to eat. Yeah, but if it is something that is like narrow enough that he can, that is like it's very close, you know, it's the same, like the same arba amot, the same like square of 2 meters, and he can see like where he started, so that won't be a problem. It will count as one place. But if it is something that is like big tree, and by moving to the other side, like he made more than like 2 meters,
We're not saying that the stick of the tree is like a mechitza.
The stick of the tree is like a mechitza if it is a mechitza, but if it is something very thin, right? So I'm saying if it is like, yeah, that's my point. If it's wide,
you can take issue with you when you go to
a tree that's the measurement is three tefachim, no? So something that stands for mechitza.
I think that for this matter it will need to be, let's say, 4 tefachim. Because we're going to the stringency of the other side, but let's leave that like a niche for another time. Yeah, we got to cafe. Yeah, cafe. צריך לברך. כיוון שהתאנה מפסקת. Why you have to say another ברכה? Because the fig tree is a break. ואינו רואה מקומו הראשון. He doesn't see his first place. Right? So that, like I said, if you do see, no problem. Mary Shalom Da Tena Betoch Hekef Mechitzot. And that's talking about a case that the fig tree is not standing inside of a like garden that is surrounded with a fence. Okay? If you're going out to the nature and you found the fig tree there, so that's the case. But if it is like a yard, so it's surrounded, so the whole yard is with Mechitzot, with the walls. The imam da betoch hekef mechitza af al pi she'en ro'eh mekomo en tzerich levarech. When you are inside of a yard that is surrounded with fence, you don't have to say the bracha. Lechashiv akol mekom echad. The whole yard is like one room. Kama shekedam le'il b'shina mekomo b'cheder echad. Right. So even if you're going from one corner of the yard to the other corner of the yard, it won't be shinui mekom. Okay. What about if you're talking about someone that is really wealthy and his yard is like huge, that he can walk and walk and walk and walk, but like there is a fence all around, but it's like a big like piece of land, then it will be a little bit too hard to say that it's like it's considered to be like one room, but
especially if you can't see from one side to the other.
Yeah. But if it was a big room, we did say that. Even though you don't see, you have like something that is like barrier, so you don't see. So it's not a problem. It's not called a change in location. But I'm saying if it's a, like something that is a really big yard, I'm not sure like what is the limits there, like how big is big. But I'm just saying like I was in like some place in Australia that it was like huge. You could like you could walk like few hours to cross that like from one fence to another fence. So something like that is like, you know, it's like to say that it's all one place, it's like maybe too much. But
we all merit having yards where we have this problem.
And all in Rabba.
Well, you can do what you do. Okay.
Yeah. It was not like a private person. It was like organized. But the point is that like there is places like that is very big and surrounded with a fence that it's so big that it's like almost impossible to say that it's one place. But
then it's usually trees.
So what? Okay. The E Mamda Betoka Mechitza can Milan Lilan. Okay, so what about if he's like moved from one tree to another? Yeah? So like it's not like from like the same tree and he's going around the tree. He's going from one tree to another. So then that's closer to what I said about the big yard. So then it becomes a big question, according to Mishnah Berurah. But even in that scenario that is moving from one tree to another, or it's a big yard that is going from one side to another, if he had in mind in the beginning that he's starting in one place and is finishing in another place, so there is opinions that will come with this one place and he doesn't have to say the another brah. Okay. So we got to the Rama. So I'm going to read the Rama now. Rama says, "V'yei sholkim mikol ma shekatuv b'siman zeh." The Rama says there is those that are arguing with all what we were discussing so far. Okay, sounds great, right? Rak sovrim. So what is that new opinion that is presenting now? Sheshinui mekom ino ela keasa chadad. What is the whole concept of changing your location according to this new opinion? Is the same thing as distracting your mind. Lachen im shina mekomo lemekom acher. So if you're changing your place to a new place, and tzich levarech, you don't have to say the bracha, ela lefnei ma sherotze lechol, just for what you want to eat now. Aval lo al ma shekvar achal, but not about what you ate before. Okay? So again, in according to that, he will have to say a motzi without bikat amazon. Yeah? He said a motzi, he ate, went outside, came back, no bikat amazon, just another amotzi. What about the glad dime? I don't know. We'll see. Okay. V'davka shelo yinich mitzad chaverim besuda v'achal midvarim shenam shenam tzrichim bracha mikomam. And that's talking about when he didn't leave it, people in the same place that he started his meal, and also he ate from other things that doesn't need bracha in their place. אבל אם מניח מקצת חברים, but if he did leave some friends there, אפילו לא הניח ואכל דברים שצריכים ברכה במקומם, so he didn't leave friends, but he ate things like bread that needs to say ברכה in their place. אפילו מי שרוצה לאכול אחר כך, someone that wants to eat afterwards, אין צריך לברך, doesn't need to say ברכה. לכן מי שפסק סעודתו והלך, so someone that made a break in his meal and went away, לבית אחר, to another house, or שהיה אוכל וקראו חברו, or he was eating and his friend called him, לדבר עמו, אפילו לפתח ביתו, to the entrance of his house, או למקור אחר, another place, שחוזר לסעודה, when he's going back to his meal, אין צריך לברך כלל, he doesn't have to say ברכה at all, והפעה צריכה ברכה מקומו לכולי אבא, because bread needs a ברכה in its place, for sure. מי הוא, אם מסיח דעתו, but if he distract his mind, שחוזר, ודאי צריך לברך. When he comes back, he have to say another bracha. Okay? Al ma sherotze le'echol achaz, whatever he wants to eat from now. Ben chiluk, ben im chazal lechum ma she'achal kvar, doesn't matter if he's coming back to the same location that he ate there, ben siyem sudato makom acher, or he finished his meal in another place. V'chen nagim b'medonot elu, that's the custom of the Ashkenazim, says the Raman, mikol makom lechatchila lo yakor imkomo, but lechatchila a person should not go out from his location below bracha without saying bracha achona. Dechayishinan shema ishkach milachzor lechol. Maybe he will go and then someone else will call him and then he will start to do something and he will forget that he ate. He forget to say bracha amazon. He forget to continue to eat. Miu lezor mitzvah overet kon shegi azman tefila mutar. But if there is like mitzvah overet, like a time limited mitzvah that he have to do it right now, otherwise it won't happen. For example, time to pray. So then it will be allowed. Okay? Let's go back and see the Mishnah Berurah. Mishnah Berurah, Kaf Vav. Yesh Cholkim. Betar Tipligi Al Hada'a Rishona. So there's two arguments here, says the Mishnah Berurah. Ha'echad, the first one, Dehem lo mitzrichi barcha lemafriya. Though this new opinion does not require that the person will say the bracha achona for what he ate before. Leolam mechamat shinui mekom, forever. He doesn't, never he needs to say for what he ate if he's continued to eat. Rak bracha lechatchila kodem sheyochal. What he needs to say is another bracha for whatever he's about to eat. Shinit, the second point, of the argument. The chashiv rak ha'asa chadat ולא כמה שסילק סעודה הראשונה לגמרי. It's not the same, the distracting the mind from the meal and a break of the meal. So here this second opinion holds that it's only distracting mind and not a break in the meal. Okay? על כורך הברכה האחרונה עולה לשניהם, and then because it's a distracting mind and not breaking the meal, so then when the person is saying the Bekat Amazon, in the end, it will cover everything, also the first part of the meal. גם סביר עליו, וגם זה שצריך ברכה ראשונה, הוא רק בעומד בסעודת פירות ומשכין. תרף אחר יציאתו, חוץ לפתח ביתו, נפסקה סעודתו. And according to that opinion, so he will need to say a new bracha, Rishona, only if it is not bread, if it's fruits or drink. But if it is bread, seems as also mezonot will be the same like bread for this matter. So it will not need the bracha Rishona. Okay. So the bread or mezonot that needs to go back and to say the bracha in its place, לא נפסקה סעודה ביציאה, the meal is not broke in by going out, אין צריך אף ברכה ראשונה, and then he doesn't need even the first ברכה, כאילו לא שינה מקומו כלל, as if he didn't change his location at all. אם לא ישיח דעתו, if he didn't change his, he didn't distract his mind from eating. Okay. I think I need a little bit of...
We should probably stop pretty soon.
Mm-hmm.
We should probably stop pretty soon.
Okay, fine. So, I'll read it. Okay, so Mishnah Berurah, Kaf Zayin. Mishnah Berurah, Kaf Zayin. Im meniach, kivan shenisharu miktatan, afilu echad mekomo, lo nefsika seudato. So if he left someone, so he didn't, it's not a break, chozrim lechol lishtot bli shum berakha, and then he can continue to eat, drink without any bracha. Af shaita mesibatan lechol porot meshkin, even though it was only fruit or drink. Mishnah Berurah kafchet, achal midvarim, katar megen Avraham siman reish yud, davka kshachal kazait. Okay, so when we speaking about the eating, what is eating? Eating is at least kazait. Okay, there's a whole argument about what is kazait, but we're not going to get into that right now. But if it is less than kazait, but kodem sheyatza, before he left the house, he ate just a bite. You know, kmo perot, so then the bread will count like fruit because he didn't start his meal yet, because he didn't eat kazait.
It says bar nefeshot?
No, not for bar nefeshot. Just for like, is it a break in the middle or not a break in the middle? The ayin tzarich levarech harav umeile miyad sheyatza lachutz tzarich bracha rishona av shechozer. So because less than chazai doesn't in bracha achrona, so there's no the obligation of coming back to his place to say bracha achrona does not apply because there's no bracha achrona here. And then because he doesn't have to come back to his place, so it's more of a zachadat, which is like fruits.
Was it enough to have less than a chazai after he said hamotzi, for there not to be an interruption between washing his hands and saying hamotzi?
Again.
So he washes his hands, says nothing to them, says hamotzi, has less than a kazait.
Yeah.
And then, okay, I'll be right out. And he goes.
That's the case that we're talking about.
Right.
Yeah.
Was the fact that he had less than a kazait after he said hamotzi enough to keep that bracha valid, let's say?
Which bracha?
Hamotzi.
A person have to say hamotzi even for less than kazait. But he doesn't have to say Bekat Amazon for less than a kazai. So the whole like premise that we said that he have to come back. Why he have to come back? He have to come back for his bracha achrona. If there's no bracha achrona, so he doesn't have to come back. So then it becomes to be like fruits.
And then it's like he didn't have a meal. He just had a small meal.
Yeah. Okay. Kaftet. או שהיה אף שלא שמוינן בבבא זו שום רבותה, even though there's no חידוש here about this, like with this new point, נקט לישנה למחבר, סניף א', פסק לאפר. So he went over whatever the מחבר said in the beginning of the סימן, and said the opposite. למד, ודאי צריך לברר, ברכה ראשונה, כדין עשה חדת. This is like the law of עשה חדת, it's striking mind. אחרי לברך בקעת המזון, להכון, and then to say, בקעת המזון, for all what he ate, the two parts of the meal, like we said. למד, א', אני מישנה ברורה, אין חילוק, אבל אילקאי, היינו באוכל דברים הטעונים ברכה במקומו, he is eating things that needs ברכה in its place, ולא הניח מקצת חברים. He doesn't leave friends there to go out his meal. Ashmin and the Av, she must say, so even though he's ending his meal, מקום אחר, in a different location, גם כן, אין צריך לברך, he doesn't need to say, and add a ברכה there. על סמך, סעודה ראשונה, אוכל, what he's eating in the second meal is according to his first meal. אבל כשאוכל דברים, טעונים ברכה מקומן, when he's eating things, that needs bracha in their place, kigon perot, like fruits, etc. Or should they mashkin, or he have drink? Av sheniach misat chaverim, even though he had some friends there, lo me'an, it will not help, ela shechozrim lechavuratan, asuda rishana. Unless they coming back to their meal, to the first meal, aval leochel, leochol, lishtot, b'mkom acher, to eat in a new location, צריכים ברכה לכתחילה, they will need another ברכה for that. Okay? Lev, I think that will be the last one for today. It's a good place to finish. Lev, סיים סעודתו, he finished his meal, okay, also the class. ואם אכל גם שם פת, if he ate bread also there, ועל כמה, מבר סעיף ד' ומברך שם בקעת המזון, he will have to say the בקעת המזון there. Ivan the Shah who seems so that because there is the end of his meal. Okay. So we'll hold it here and Bezrat Hashem, tomorrow we'll continue with the Lamed Gimel. Bracha v'atzlacha for everybody.